Hello everybody and welcome back to On the Creek. For today's video, you're going to come along with me and my buddy Jeff on a small game hunt. We actually have a coyote hunt planned, and since we were going to do some scouting, we figured we'd bring along our shotguns and see how we can do a small game. I will say this though, we are going to be actively hunting and looking to take game, so viewer discretion is advised, and I hope you enjoy the video. Don't forget to take a minute to like and subscribe. If you like outdoors and seeing fishing and hunting, because we're doing it all the time, and I'm going to be posting videos every week. So enjoy the video, everybody. Thanks. For today's hunt, we chose Point Mulet State Game Area. This is an area that is premier for waterfowl, and it's managed very strictly for that. However, it still offers many opportunities for other types of game, small game deer, coyote, and plenty of fishing as well. So this is a great spot that's close to where we live, and we use it readily. But it is in a populated area, so we do see a lot of hunting traffic and other pedestrian traffic, people walking their dogs, so sometimes that can be kind of a pain. But it's what we have, so we make the best of it. For today's hunt, we chose to go into this field, and we're actually scouting for a coyote hunt that we have planned, but we're going to try and get some small game. The week leading up to this hunt, we got plenty of rain, over 3 inches. A lot of our rivers were at flood stage, and the entry on this field wasn't so bad, but when we got in some of the lower lying areas, it was pretty flooded out and prohibited us from using the area and hunting it like we would have if it was dry. But hey, we made the best of it. We got out in the woods, and that's what it's all about. So at this point, we've made it all the way around this field we came in on, and we've seen plenty of coyote signs, so that's good for us. Scouting aspect, we decided we're going to hunt this field, so we then started to switch gears into the small game hunting. We moved into a patch of woods on the side of the field, and finding a dry place to cross and get in there was kind of tough, but once we found one, we were in, and we started looking for raccoons or squirrels. And our method for that is usually watch from around the ground, but today's hunt, that was tough because a lot of the ground was underwater, which kept the animals kind of up in the tree. We were watching for like the nests up in the trees. Sometimes you can catch a squirrel tail sticking out, and you know he's in there, and you put a round through the nest, and out he comes. With as what as it was and not having a whole lot of action, we decided to try and move down the road and find drier ground. But even at the second spot, we find out real quick that it's going to be pretty wet and we may not have a whole lot of luck.
Thank you. seconds of boat launch.
With the second spot being a total washout as well, we decided to give it a shot and try one more spot that I was familiar with. I've hunted this spot before for deer, and it was a pretty good stand of trees. However, when we arrived at the spot, we found that they were doing some active management and had clear-cut a large, if not almost all, of the stand of woods. And we decided to walk it anyways and see if we could stir anything up, and we did actually see a little bit of action in the spot.
Thank you.
Thanks everybody for watching to the end. This was definitely a successful day. We did some good scouting. We got out in the woods, which is always great. And at the end there, Jeff was able to take a squirrel. It was off camera, unfortunately. But it was about getting out in the woods, and we did that. And it was a good time. Thanks for watching, everybody. And don't forget to like and subscribe.